Again to this lesson, it is titled Differences Between God's Predestination and Allah's Determination. I ask God to bless you, and I ask that you listen and watch to the end, because I know you will be blessed. Amen. Now, what is Allah's determination? I define Allah's determination as Allah choosing those who will go to paradise or hell even before they are born. Their destination is not by their individual choices, but it is only by the sole plan and agenda of Allah. That is how I define Allah's determination. Let us turn to volume 6, book 60 of Hadith, book volume 6. Book 60, Hadith number 3. And then I will intercede, and Allah will fix a limit for me to intercede, whom I will let into paradise. Then I will come back for the third time, and then I will come back for the fourth time, and we will see. None remains in hell but those whom the Quran has imprisoned in hell, and who have been destined to an eternal stay in hell. The compiler Abu Abdullah said, "But those whom the Quran has imprisoned in hell refers to the statement of Allah, they will dwell therein forever." So this is what the Hadith is saying. Muhammad is saying that Allah will fix a limit for him to intercede. So he will start interceding for people who are supposed to go into paradise. He will come back first, second, third time, fourth time, and then we will intercede. And then what? Till now, and we will say, now remains in hell. Listen, then Allah will tell him, now remains in hell, but those whom the Quran has imprisoned in hell, and who have been destined to an eternal stay in hell. So Allah is saying that as he goes to Muhammad is saying, as he goes to Allah to pray, interceding for people who are in hell or who are supposed to go to paradise and so on, as he intercedes, Allah told him that those who are remaining in hell are dead because the Quran has already imprisoned them in hell. And secondly, they are in hell because they have already been destined to have an eternal stay in hell. I hope you understand. So the Quran already imprisons some people before they are born. And some he destined that they should by all means go to hell. I have been having some discussions on Facebook, and many Muslims come there to interact with me. And I brought this topic, and a Muslim brought plenty verses, about 6 verses, to tell me that Muhammad has given everybody the free will. Allah has given everybody the free will to do what he or she thinks is good, and that will determine where he or she will go, whether hell or paradise. I know these verses, and I want to quote at least 2 of the verses that he brought. That is Surah chapter 18, verse number 29. Surah 18:29 says, "And say, the truth is from your Lord. Whoever wills, let him believe, and whoever wills, let him disbelieve. We have prepared for the just a fire, whose curtains will hem them in. And when they cry for relief, they will be relieved with water like molten brass, which scalds their faces with a miserable drink, and what a miserable drink, and what a terrible place." Let us read this hadith also, this Quran also, Quran 17 verse 15. "Whoever he is guided for his own good. And whoever goes astray to his own detriment. No burdened soul carries the burden of another, nor do we ever punish until we have sent a messenger." So the Quran here is saying that it is God, Allah gives people the will to choose whether they will serve him or they will reject him. Do you understand? And no one carries anybody's burden. Like saying Jesus Christ, like what the Bible said, Jesus Christ came to carry the burden of all the people on this earth. They are saying that nobody carries everybody's burden. Everybody carries his own burden. Every soul carries his own burden. That is what the 17 verse 15 is trying to say. But now let us look at the other at this end Quran. Let's say to volume 6, Book 60, Hadith number 473. Hadith number 473. It says, it is narrated by Ali. It says, I want to read the last part. It's a long thing. I want to read the last part. It says, the Prophet, peace be to him, said, those who are destined to be happy in the hereafter will find it easy and pleasant to do the deeds of characteristics of those destined to happiness. While those who are to be among the miserable in the hereafter will find it easy to do the deeds, characteristics of those destined to misery. Then he recited, as for him who gives in charity and keeps his duty to Allah and believes in the best reward from Allah. So what is this hadith saying? What is this hadith saying? He's saying that people who have been destined to go to paradise, they find it very easy to do good. And those who have been destined to go to hell, they find it very easy to do bad. I hope you understand what the hadith is saying. Mm-hmm. So Allah has already destined or determined that some people should do good or should do bad. But you tell me that, but that's not what the verse is saying. Let us look at Sahih Muslim 2657b, where it talks about fornication and adultery. And this passage, I quoted it in my other video concerning Allah determines the number of fornication a person should indulge in before he is born. I quote Sahih Muslim 2657b. Listen very carefully. It is reported by Abu Hurairah. He says, Allah's Messenger is saying, verily Allah speaks the very portion of adultery that is sin that a man will indulge in. There will be no escape from it, of which he of necessity must commit. The adultery of the eye is the lustful look, and the adultery of the tongue is the licentious speech. The heart desires a yes, which the past day or may not put into the heart, into effect. Sahih Muslim 2657b. So, this Sahih Muslim is saying that Allah has fixed the very portion of adultery, which in Arabic is called zina, which a man will indulge in. And he says there will be no escape from it. And it's of necessity that the person should by all means go through it. Because Allah has fixed it already. The portion of adultery somebody should commit. So my brother, my sister, when you see a prostitute on the roadside, remember it was Allah who destined. It was Allah who fixed the portion of adultery that girl should go through. When you see a man loving a man, a homosexual, the hadith is simply telling us that it was Allah who fixed the very portion of homosexuality or lesbianism or supi that this girl or man should go through. So before a Muslim come into this world, or before somebody come into this world, if he's ruled by Allah, or if Allah is supposed to be there, supposed to be God, yeah? If Allah is supposed to be the man of the universe, Allah or the creator of the universe, Allah is saying that before you come down to this earth, he has actually put into your DNA what you will be, whether you will be an armed robber, whether you will be a thief, whether you will be a madman, whether you will be a prostitute, whether you will be a lecturer, whether you will be an engineer, whether you will be a pilot, whether you will be whatever you want to be, whether you be a pilot, whether you be an armed robber, whether you be a suicide bomber, Allah has already put into your DNA what you should be. And then at the end of the day, he will decide where he will put you, whether he will put you into paradise or will put you into hell. It is not by your choice, according to the Quran, according to the Hadith, Sahih Bukhari. Let's look at now the Christian predestination. When you look into the dictionary, this is the definition of destination. From the English dictionary, it says, predestination in Christianity is a doctrine that God has eternally chosen those whom he intends to save. Predestination has been especially associated with John Calvin and the Reformed tradition. This doctrine is saying, that is the English dictionary, is saying that predestination is God has eternally chosen those whom he God intends to save. But I want to say that this definition is wrong. It's not Bible. That is what they, the those who wrote the English Bible or whatever Bible, the English dictionary or whatever dictionary or whatever theological book, this is the definition they have. But that's not what the Bible is saying. That is not how the Bible defines predestination. Now this is how I define predestination. I define predestination as because the omniscient God is all-knowing, the omniscient God who is all-knowing gives us the choices. Because he has made us in his image, his imago Dei. And because of his all-knowing attributes, he has predestined those who he knows will have faith in him and will have salvation because he found you. I want to say it again. Predestination is the omniscient God knowing the choices we will make based on he creating us in his imago Dei or in his image. And due to his all-knowing attributes, he predestined us to salvation because he knows the future faith we will have and the merits he foreknew. Because God knew before the world starts that these people, when I create him, this man, when he is born, he will have faith in me, he will trust in me, he will believe in me, he will not go to the devil. And because of God's merit, he foreknew, he knows that this person will come to me. So he predestinates the person. So it's the person's choice, not the determination of God. It is we who decide. And because of our decision, God predestines us. Let us turn to Romans chapter number 8. Romans 8, verse 29 to 30. Romans 8, 29 to 30. Let's read Romans 8, 29 to 30. It says, for whom he foreknew, he foreknow, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Moreover, verse 30, moreover, whom he predestined, them he also called. And whom he called, them he also justified. And whom he justified, them he also glorified. Hallelujah. So the Bible here is saying that because God foreknew or he foreknew, he predestined people. And then when he predestined, he conformed them. Because he knows who chose him, he predestined us. That before we came into the world, he said, you will come to me, because he knows we will come to him. So he predestined us. He was conformed us to be like Jesus Christ. And then what? He then called us, justified us, glorified us. This is what the Bible is saying. Romans chapter 8, 29 to 30. Let's turn to Genesis chapter 18. Genesis chapter 18, 17 to 19. To know more about God's predestination. To know more about God's foreknowledge. To know more about how God moves on in this world. We need to know how God moves on in this world. For us to understand God well, I want us to understand, take this example also. Genesis chapter 18, verse number 19 going, verse number 17 going. And he said, Shall I hide this from Abraham? That thing which I do, verse 18, seeing that Abraham shall surely become a great and mighty nation, and all the nations of the earth shall be blessed in him. Verse 19, listen very carefully, verse 19. For I know that he, that's Abraham, will command his children and his household after him, and they shall keep the way of the Lord to do justice and judgment, and the Lord may bring upon Abraham that which he has spoken of him. Because God knew who Abraham will be in the future, God predestined, God chose him. He said that he knew that Abraham would command his children to follow him. At the time God was speaking, Abraham did not have a child.
You see, so God chose Abraham to be his somebody great, to be the father of many nations, because he knows what Abraham will be. Hallelujah. The same God, when he called Jeremiah, he told Jeremiah, Jeremiah, before you were born, I knew you. And I called you as a prophet. Before Jeremiah was born, God knows that when Jeremiah is born, Jeremiah will love him so much. So God called Jeremiah and made him a prophet, even before Jeremiah was born. Because God foreknew that Jeremiah will love him. Because God foreknew that Jeremiah, when he comes here on earth, when he comes here on earth, will do the biddings of God. So God chose him. I believe that before I was born, God knows I will be a pastor teacher. So before my father loved my mother and they gave birth to me and called me Afute, God knew that this is what I would be doing. So God called me and called me as a pastor. They called me as a pastor teacher. Hallelujah. So because God foreknew, he was, he predestined us. I want us to understand something. See, I want you to see this as the days, as timeline. The days, the weeks, the months, the years, the decades, the generations, the centuries, the millenniums. You see, this is the beginning of time. This is the end of time. There is eternity past and eternity beginning and eternity past, eternity beginning and eternity past. Do you understand? We have eternity and then eternity past, then eternity future. Yeah, that's the right way. Eternity past and then eternity future. I want you to understand something. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, Bereshit in the Hebrew, Bereshit bara Elohim ashamahim ha-yiret wa-tohu wa-bohu. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. So there was a time when there was a beginning. And everything that existed before the beginning is called God. Because the eternity past, there was no beginning. All those in the before the time starts to tick, they are called God. So Bereshit bara Elohim ashamahim ha-yiret wa-tohu wa-bohu. The beginning God created the heavens and the earth, and the earth was void, and the earth was formless. That's what Genesis 1 verse 1 and 2 says. So God created Adam and Eve, Adam and his wife Eve. God created them. This is the beginning of time. God created them, Adam and Eve, and then what? As they move, they kept on. They gave birth to many children. All type of children. They gave birth to many children. Eh? God take this one to be end of time, death, when everybody dies. God, and then let's take this to be heaven, and let's take this to be hell. God knew that all the trillions, the billions of people who will be born here, God, who is here, who foreknew, who knows the end from the beginning, he knows that when a human being dies, you know, the human being died, he knows that the human being will either go to hell or heaven. He knows it already. So those who go to hell, he has predestined where they will go to already. Because he, God, who knows the end from the beginning, knows that this person at the end of the day will go to heaven or will go to hell. I hope you understand. So this is death. This is the end of time for everybody. And when we die, we end up in heaven or we end up in hell. God, who knows the end from the beginning, know that this man, Christolite, will choose me as his personal savior and Lord. So he predestined me. And he said, I will be in heaven. The Bible says in Romans 13 verse 8, that the Lamb was slain before the foundation of the earth. Because God knows that man will sin before he created man, the Lamb of God, Jesus Christ, has been slain already. before the earth was founded. That's what Revelation 13 verse 8 says. God, who knows the beginning, calls those things that be not as though they were. Because God knows the end from the beginning, He called people and He predestined them that they'll become His children. He did not choose them, He did not determine. It was God of we deciding to accept Him. So, based upon our decision, God chose us. God chose us. That is God's predestination. That is God's, that is what is known as God's foreknowledge. God didn't. God chose us because we have already chosen Him. Because He has given us the imago Dei. He has made us in His image and likeness. That we have a choice. God will make us like zombie. But when it comes to Allah, Allah's own is like zombie. He determines where you should go. Your life has been planned. Your DNA has been planned already. And then He decides to put you in paradise or put you in hell. Because God knows those who will choose Him when they are born, He has already programmed them. So let me say something here that will be some of you might not understand. Let me say something here right now. Listen very, very carefully. There are some people presently alive who are not Christians, who are not born again. Who, according to our thinking, they are going straight to hell. But the omnipotent, omniscient God, who knows the end from the beginning, knows that this Muslim man, who you keep on condemning in your heart, this atheist, who is even saying that there is no God, this Baha'i, this homosexual, this person who doesn't hate God presently, this traditionalist, God who knows tomorrow, who knows the end, knows that this person will end up in heaven or hell. And I'm telling you, there's some people who are Muslims right now. They are traditionalists. They are juju people. They hate God. They are atheists. But because God knows tomorrow, God knows that they will be in heaven. So God has predestinated them. God has, because of His foreknowledge, He has predestinated them. But because they are right now not Christian, they have not been conformed to the image of Christ. Because they don't have Christ in them. But by the end of their time on earth, because they will later accept this Christ as their personal savior, God has predestined them. I recall my father, for many, many, many years, I was praying for him. I had to do things for my father to come to Christ. And the day my father died, I knew my father has gone to hell. But the Lord told me one afternoon when I was bathing, the Lord told me, your father is dead. I said that with you because I know my father is really going to hell. He's not a bad man. He actually built two churches. He actually built two churches with his man. My son brother told me it was three. An Anglican church, a Methodist church, and now a Baptist church. He built his homes. He built them. He built the Baptist church from scratch. And then he gave them the Anglican church big money when they were just at this level. And he finished, they completed their project. I knew my father had gone to hell. The Lord told me that, no, your father has gone to hell. I said, how? He said, when you go home, go and ask your elder sister Rose. When they had asked my elder sister Rose, and my sister told me, 3 days before our father died, she went to the hospital, spoke to my father, led my father to Christ, so my father has gone to heaven. You see, 3 days before my father died, my father accepted Christ. Not knowing all the years my father was staying on earth, because God knows tomorrow, God has predestined that my father will be in heaven. God didn't force him to come to Him. But God, who knows tomorrow, knows that the last 3 days of his life, He will accept Him as His personal Savior and Lord. So He predestined him. Hallelujah. So the old lady, the man who, the armed robber, you know in your area, you have to be fine with everybody. You have to love your enemies, everybody, because you don't know where they will be in future. It's only God. That's why the Bible says that we should not judge. And the judgment here is condemnation, condemning people into hell. Not judging when you sin and think that what you have done is a sin. But saying that this person is going to hell, that judgment, let us leave it to God. Because he is all knowing and he knows those who finally will end up in heaven and hell. So he has predestined people. Now let us turn again to the Quran, the Hadith, the Islamic book. Sunan Abi Dawood 4614 is said by Khalid al-Harhara. And Khalid al-Harhara said, I said al-Hassan, Abu said, tell me about Adam. Was he created for the heaven or the earth? He said, no, for the earth. I said, it was unavailable for him. I said, tell me about the following verse of the Quran. Can lead any into temptation concerning Allah, except such as themselves, going to the blazing fire. He said, the devils do not lead anyone astray by their temptation, except the one whom Allah destines to go to hell. So we are talking about the determination of Allah against the predestination of God. And the Hadith here is saying, Sunan Abi Dawood is saying that when people think they are tempted by the devil, it is not the devil who is tempting them, but it is because Allah has destined them to go to hell. The devils will not lead anyone astray by their temptation, except the one whom Allah has destined to hell. So those who Allah has destined that is go to hell, the devil tempts them because Allah has said that they should go to hell, and then God, Allah sends them to hell. Yes. I have some questions. If Allah has already put into the genes of people what they should be in future, so that he can put them into hell, don't you think Allah is determining how human beings should be? He has determined already, like we quoted from the Quran. Let me take it this way. If God has given you a father and a mother to determine what should be in your son or daughter before they are born, and you decide to put the genes of homosexuality, to put the genes of lesbianism, to be and so on, armed robbery, and then you and then your son is not seeing with any girl, and then on his 37th birthday, he brings a bearded man, macho man, and then you are thinking that is another friend of your son, 37-year-old son. And then he said that he will be asking me, telling me when I will marry. And then this your son introduced this bearded macho man, face looking like an armed robber, to you, and tells you, daddy, this is the man I am going to marry. Will you say that your son is mental, has mental problem? When you are given the ability to determine what to be in your son, you place this thing in your son, or you have your daughter, and then you put the genes of lesbianism, you put the genes of you put the genes of prostitution into your daughter, and then your daughter sleeps with about 5 men in the night, and you can walk. That is why you're breaking my heart. That is not how your mother is. That is not how, and so on. And then your daughter tells you that, daddy, mommy, this is what you put in me. You determine how I should be before I was born. Do you think the father and the mother have the right to say their son or daughter are guilty or are bad? That is what Allah did in the verses we have quoted. Allah determines what somebody should be before the person is born. There's a certain book. This book is written by one Khalid, Muhammad Khalid. And the proximity of the book says something. Says something I want us to listen. I want you to listen very carefully. The proximity, I quote, for those of you who don't read the Arabic, Abu Bakr don't promise paradise by Allah and his prophets and his apostle. Why we be says, by Allah, I will not feel safe from the deception of Allah, even if I had 1 foot in paradise. Abu Bakr, this Abu Bakr is a friend of Muhammad. He's actually the father. He's actually the father-in-law of Muhammad. It was his daughter Aisha that Muhammad married at 6 years and had sex with her at 9 years. I know some of you will say that, why is it spoiling Muhammad? Oh, I'm not spoiling Muhammad. I am telling you what even your hadith says. And what Aisha said in the hadith. If you like, I'll quote it for you. I'll make another video and then I'll quote it for you in that video. That's not the topic we are dealing with here. And this is Abu Bakr, who later became a friend to Apostle of Muhammad's Allah's Apostle. He had come to realize that this Allah is like someone who can change his mind and abrogate things that he has said at any time through Muhammad. So when he was about to die, he was weeping and he was saying that this Allah,
he doesn't even trust him.
He doesn't even trust him. And this is due to an hadith. This was being written on a hadith. When you read volume 1, book 1, hadith number 76. Let us read. I'll read some short parts. I don't read all. He says, and it's said by Abdullah bin Masudi. He says, then Allah sends the angel to him and commands him to write down four things. He says, write down one is this, two his lifespan, three his provision, and four whether he is doomed and destined for hell or blessed and destined for paradise. By the one whose hand is my soul, one of you may do the deeds of the people of. Now listen, look. He said, now one of you may do the deeds of the people of paradise until there is no more than the four arms length between him and it. Then the decree overtakes him, and he does the deeds of the people of hell until there is no more than a forearm. Until there is no more than a forearm length between him, and he does the deeds of paradise until he enters therein. So the hadith is saying that Abu Bakr doesn't trust this man, this Allah, when he was about to die, because Allah can just abrogate whatever he has said through Muhammad. And he's saying that even if he has placed you in paradise, and your forearm is in paradise, and then Allah will call for the things he has said about you, the four things he has said about you. And then the last one is decree. If his decree says that you are destined to go to hell, if you see in paradise, Abu Bakr is like, if his one food is in paradise, Allah will be throwing him into hell. So he was weeping and he said, he doesn't trust Allah. He does not trust Allah at all, because Allah is somebody who can deceive. So when you take to Surah chapter 7 verse 79, this is what it says, the Surah. Chapter 7 verse 79, it says that, and are they then secure from Allah's deception? Makra Allahi. Man deemeth himself secure from Allah's deception. Makra Allahi. Save for that perish. Surah 7 verse 99. No one is secure through Allah's deception. Makra Allahi. It's only those who are doomed for hell. Those who already have spent them in hell. Their destiny has been settled. So they have no fear. They're already in hell. Makra Allahi. You cannot trust Allah. He determines where you should go before you are even born. But the God of Yahweh, the Yahweh God, the one who is called Yahweh, the God of Israel, the God of the Jews, the God of the Christians, does not determine where you should go. He has given you the free choice. Romans 8:29 says that, for whom he foreknow, he predestined. So when God, because he is unknown, he foreknow, he knows those who come to him. He knows those who come to him. So for those he foreknow, one, he predestinates them. And then three, he confirmed them. And then four, he called them. And then he justified them. He glorified them. God has not determined where I should go to. No. God has not determined where I should go to. God has not determined. He has given us the free will to choose him. Whether we will go to heaven or we'll go to hell. May God bless you. May the love of God touch you. May whatever you cry for in life touch you. And may you know that God has chosen you to love him. And God has given you the free will to love him. It is your choice. Thank God that Allah is not silver, is not the one that will determine where I should be. So when you give your life to Jesus Christ, he will tell, you would know that he has chosen you because you will give your life to him when you are born. May God bless you. Before you go, don't forget to subscribe if you have not subscribed to my channel. Gmail, the YouTube will tell you that in case you don't have a Gmail account, you tell you to create a Gmail account. Please, just create it. When you create it, it will not ask you again. And you have the ability to like my videos and to subscribe to it. Please don't go, just do it. And I know God will bless you. If you are watching this video, not on YouTube or wherever, go to YouTube, go to Dr. Nimoche Crystallize YouTube. And then go and subscribe. And I know God will bless you. May the peace of God that passes all understanding be your portion. In Jesus' name, amen.